How's it going, everyone? It is Pangino here, and in this video, I'm going to be showing you how you can clear your AMD Radeon GPU shader cache. This is quick and easy to do. There are a few different methods in which you can follow to do this, and you might be wondering what the benefits of doing this are. Well, if you happen to be experiencing any FPS stutters, lower than expected performance, graphics issues, or just lower FPS after a certain game has had an update, one of the first things that I would do to any GPU, whether it's an NVIDIA GPU, AMD GPU, or Intel GPU, is clear the GPU shader cache. Once the shader cache has been cleared, when you boot into any and all of your favorite games, the shaders will then be recompiled, which could potentially fix any issues you might be running into. Get Windows activated for a great price with Hookies. Use the links below for Windows 11, Windows 10, or Office. Apply code PAN20 at checkout for an additional 25% off. Secure payment options, including PayPal, are available. Once complete, just paste the key to activate Windows and remove the watermark. Windows 10 keys can also upgrade to Windows 11. Use the links in the description below, and thank you to Hookies for sponsoring. Now, this is more of system maintenance rather than an optimization. You shouldn't experience much of an FPS boost from doing this, especially if you aren't experiencing any issues, but it's just like clearing cache out of your system. If you happen to be experiencing slowdowns or performance that isn't expected, first thing I would do is clear the GPU shader cache and see if this fixes your issues. This works across the board on all AMD Radeon GPUs, from high-end, low-end, desktop, laptop, old or new. This video will also go over a few other quick tips and tricks in case you are still running into performance issues after following this guide to help you get the most out of your system and get back to just playing and enjoying your games with the performance that you've come to expect. For the best results, I'd recommend that you follow as many of these steps as possible. Starting off with the most simple option, navigate down to your Windows task tray, go to your AMD Radeon software. Inside of the AMD software, go to the top to the Gaming tab, then go down to Graphics. Inside of the Graphics tab, scroll all the way towards the bottom. You may have to open some drop-down menus to get all the way down here. You'll then be able to find the option for Reset Shader Cache. To do this, just simply press the Perform Reset, select OK. Then all of the shaders should be cleared out of your system. I would then recommend quickly restarting your PC before continuing on. Now, most of the shaders should have been cleared out throughout that process, but in many cases, they are not. So I'm quickly going to show you how you can also manually remove some GPU shaders so you can have everything cleared out completely to ensure that you get the best results when you do this. On your PC, go down to your Windows button in Windows 11 or Windows 10, then search for Run and press Enter. Alternatively, you can just press and hold the Windows key and R on your keyboard. Inside of the run box, we need to search for %localappdata%. Typed just like this, you can also find this to copy and paste in the description below. Select OK. Inside of the AppData local folder, go to AMD. Inside of here, you'll have a few different cache folders available to you. We'll start with DX cache. Go inside of this folder, highlight and select any and all files within inside of here. If there are quite a few, you can simply select one file, then press Ctrl and A on your keyboard to select all. Once they're all selected, right click and select delete. When you're doing this, if you've had your PC turned on for a little while, you'll more than likely not be able to delete all of the files within inside of here because some of those files might currently be in use. If that is the case, just simply select do this for all current items for now, select try again. If it still doesn't work, select do this for all current items, then select skip. If you're having difficulty removing any and all shaders from any of these caching folders, as you're getting the message that they are currently in use, we can get around this and remove them completely from the system if we reboot into Windows Safe Mode. The reason you want to reboot into Safe Mode is because the GPU driver will no longer be in use whilst you're in Safe Mode. So we can successfully remove all of the shaders from the GPU because it's not currently being used. To boot into Windows Safe Mode, find the left shift key on your keyboard and press and hold the left shift key. Right click on the power button and select restart, whilst continuing to hold the shift key. After a few short moments, you'll be brought into this screen. We want to select the second option for troubleshoot. We're then going to select the middle option of startup settings, then select restart. When the system restarts, we're going to be enabling option 4, so press number 4 on your keyboard to boot Windows Safe Mode. When you're logged into Windows Safe Mode, press the Windows button and search for Run. Alternatively, press the Windows key and R on your keyboard. Search for %localappdata%, then select OK. Go back inside of the AMD folder. You may also find in Safe Mode that you're able to see more cache folders available to you. Start by going into any and all of the folders labeled cache and feel free to remove the files from those. So I'll start by going into DX9 cache, selecting Ctrl and A to select all, or just highlighting everything and selecting delete. Then go back to the AMD folder at the top of the directory. I can then go down to DX Cache, select any and all of the shaders within inside of this folder, highlight those and delete them. Go back to the AMD folder by pressing back or going to the navigation bar and selecting AMD again, then going down to DXC Cache, clearing everything, and just repeating this step for all of the cache folders. CL.cache we can ignore, but every other folder labeled cache we can clear the files out from. Once you've successfully deleted all of the shaders from all caching folders, take yourself over to the desktop, find the recycling bin, empty the recycling bin. We can then take ourselves down to the Windows button, right click on that power button and select restart to boot Windows back into its standard mode. When you've booted back into Windows, you should then have successfully removed all of those shaders from your AMD GPU driver. Once that's been completed, we're going to go and press the Windows button once again, this time searching for Disk Cleanup. Select the Disk Cleanup utility, we're going to select our C drive and select OK. Now you can take this opportunity to clear out some extra space on your system by deleting temporary files and other disk cleanup files with inside of here. The main option we're going to be looking for the purpose of this video is the DirectX shader cache, but if you want to, you can select any and all of the other options available with inside of here to clear out some space and do some maintenance on your system. Go down to OK, select delete files and wait for the disk cleanup utility to be completed. Once the disk cleanup utility has been completed, it should automatically close itself out. One extra step that you could potentially look into after this video is doing a complete fresh GPU driver install. There are two ways you can do this. You can utilize the clean install option when installing a new GPU driver, whether it's an NVIDIA driver, Intel driver or AMD driver for your system. Those options are available for all three GPU brands, but you can also utilize DDU or Display Driver Uninstaller. This application allows you to remove any and all GPU drivers from your system completely, so you can start fresh as if you never had the GPU installed, then install a brand new driver to your system to have a complete fresh start. Now you don't need to utilize DDU every single time you update your GPU driver. I would actually recommend going with the clean install option instead, just for GPU driver updates, and I will have a video coming on that very soon to the channel. So make sure that you are subscribed for when that goes live. If you happen to be playing a game that has shader pre-compilation when you boot the game first up, whether it's every time you boot the game or if it restarts this process after the game gets a major update, there may be an instance where you can force that shader pre-compilation to restart to build the shaders again from scratch. So if you are playing a game such as Call of Duty or Marvel or a different game that has the option to restart the shader cache process, after a major update, if you are experiencing less performance, small stutters, or things just don't feel right compared to how they were, the first thing that I would do is recommend that you look for that setting if it's available in the game you're having the issues with and restart the shader cache process. Don't tab out of the game or do anything whilst the shader cache is building. And once it's complete, boot into the game and see if that fixes your issue first. If it doesn't, I would recommend utilizing the perform shader cache reset setting in the drivers. If that doesn't work, move over to the manual steps of clearing your shader cache as showcased in this video. And last but not least, if you're still experiencing issues, consider doing a complete clean driver reinstallation utilizing the clean install option when installing a new driver or updating, or going further with that and utilizing DDU to do a complete wipe of your GPU drivers. Once you've done any and all of those steps, if you still happen to be experiencing any issues in your games, first thing I would look at is your GPU temperature and your GPU usage. Consider lowering some of the in-game settings, consider clearing out your system of any dust. Monitoring your performance statistics alongside your GPU temperature can easily be done in Steam's heavily updated overlay, which you can enable by going into your Steam in-game settings and switching this setting on. Alternatively, if you'd like more information on this overlay and how to set it up and get the most out of it, make sure to check out the video in the card at the top right-hand side of the screen or linked in the description down below for the Steam overlay. Increasing the fan speed of your GPU and CPU, which could potentially fix those issues. And if you're still experiencing issues after that point, the next step I would recommend is to consider a clean install of Windows. You can back up all of your files. It's actually relatively quick and easy to do these days, and it's something I would recommend doing around about once every 18 months or so on a gaming PC anyway. Windows can get bloated over time. You'll have tons of programs, games, and bloat installed to your system or remaining files from games that you no longer play. And for the best results, I would highly recommend that you do consider that if you're still experiencing issues. I have videos covering most of these topics, which you can find in the description of this video alongside playlists that you might find useful. And if this video has happened to help you fix your issue, or if you've been able to send this over to a friend and it's fixed their issues, please do let me know of your results in that comment section down below. Any other tips or tricks you may also have. Thank you ever so much for taking the time to watch this video, and I'll see you in the next one.